wrote this one for George Harrison. Because he was a very, very, very special being. I think he was human. I'm not quite sure. But you know, they talk in yoga, they talk about, they don't talk about, people take names. Like Jeffrey Kegel became Krishnadas because he was named by his guru. That's the tradition, you know? And sometimes, maybe we name ourselves, you know? Who knows where we get our names? But one thing that George Harrison did, which I believe was unlike any other spiritual being in the world, was he named himself before he was even born. You see, he knew that being a Beatle was going to be a tremendous responsibility, you know, spiritually, that he was going to introduce yoga in such a big way. And he didn't want to lose his north node. You know, he didn't want to lose his point of life. Now, many times, you know, when we sing kirtan, and he loved Krishna, Krishna was his favorite, you know, we sing the names of, like, the name of Krishna, you know? But Krishna has many names. One of Krishna's names is Hari. So while George was sitting there up in heaven between incarnations, and he was like, who am I going to be? He said, well, just to make sure I know where I'm going to be, he says, I'm going to be Hari's son.
Oh.
This is devoted to Hari's son, who is now probably one with Hari's son. And we'll start just by singing the name Krishna. It goes, Krishna.
Thank you. Sure.